Water.
Earth.
Fire.
Air.
Long ago, the four nations lived together in harmony. Then, everything changed when the corona attacked.
Welcome to the sixth and final week of the Avatar Olympics COVID Games. It is the final event of the competition, Mario Party. But quickly, let's go take a quick look at the standings, see where everyone's at. We've got the Water Nation 2 points clear at the top, meaning a second place finish or better will almost guarantee him the victory in the COVID Games. The four nations will be competing in a 20-turn game on Megafruit Paradise, a tropical-themed map consisting of four connected islands. For those of you that aren't familiar with the digital board game that is Mario Party, let me give you a quick overview. The object of the game is to win by collecting the most stars. You can collect a star by reaching the star space, or on this particular map, by giving 30 coins to Lakitu if you pick the right present over here. Players roll the dice to move. After each player moves, everyone plays a minigame. With that in mind, let's get into the action. Now, we've got Koopa Troopa representing the Water Nation here, the Fire Nation represented by Bowser, Boo representing the Air Nation, and Monty Mole representing the Earth Nation. We're right into our first minigame here, Slapparazzi, where the contestants are trying to stand as close to the center as possible in the picture. Whoever is in the center gets the most points, and as we see, Koopa Troopa ekes out a one-point win over the Fire Nation. That's going to give him the coin lead heading into these first couple turns. Quick check of the standings, and Koopa Troopa, the Water Nation, in first place, second place to the Air Nation. Monty Mole has bought a golden pipe at the secret shop at the bottom left. That golden pipe can transport you to the closest star. Very important. We're on to Sphere-mongers. Monty Mole, a huge five-point lead there, but the Fire Nation, Bowser, catching up. It's 20-20. Monty Mole picks up two gold. Oh, he loses one. He gets it back, but he fumbles it at the end. And that opens up the Fire Nation there to pick up those last two golden balls and win the event. Monty Mole staying on that bottom left side. I have to wonder if he's going to keep trying to rack up those golden pipes. Looks like Bowser's gained an ally. Now, it's important to note that allies, they're just basically friends that'll help you roll the dice and you get access to their dice blocks. It's possible that that could be a bonus star at the end, so the most allies... Oh, looks like we've got a disconnect here in this tug-of-war game. Looks like Bowser was going too hard against Monty Mole. Still lost. Monty Mole in the championship versus Koopa Troopa. Monty Mole wins. That's a good win for the Earth Nation. Bowser's purchased his own golden pipe there, but too many golden pipes bought, and that shop will close, so that is not an option for Lawn. It looks like Monty Mole is trying to go for another one. Yes, that's two right there. And the Fire Nation there, Bowser, he's going to use his golden pipe to get the star. As I said, so important to get those, and then pick up another golden pipe. That's just going to make it too hot, and that ice cream melts, closing the shop. Next up is It's the Pits. In this case, the contestants are going to be standing on these rotating platforms that are going to fall out from underneath them. Still anyone's game. And just the Fire Nation survives the last one. That's a win for Bowser. Looks like another star coming out for the Fire Nation. He's up to three. It's quite a tight race here. Really, anyone can win. Let's look at this minigame. Looks like we've actually got some in-game audio. Pay attention to Yoshi in the teal. His teammate is off. It's just this CPU Yoshi here. Almost fell off.
No, I knocked myself off. Why am I doing that?
Come on, Yoshi!
Come on, Yoshi.
Yes!
Daisy, no! My lady. That's really funny.
What a performance there by that Yoshi. Almost got knocked out. It looked like three times before he just comes back and manhandles Daisy at the end. Looks like it's another star, though, for Bowser here. He's up to four. It's a strong lead for him. Fun little Matryoshka doll game here. You're trying to follow the one with the most dolls, and it looks like Monty Mole picked the one with almost nothing in it. That's an awful performance from him. He'll be disappointed. He usually considers himself quite good at those types of games. We've got another 2v2 minigame. This is a pie-throwing one. It's very close, actually, so it looks like Monty Mole and Boo are in the lead, but just at the end, the Fire Nation and the Water Nation, Koopa Troopa and Bowser, they get it. Koopa Troopa able to find Lakitu in the presence. He's going to steal a star. We've got a nice little rolling minigame here.
So long. Ah. Oh, no!
I don't know if you guys saw that. Look at this photo finish here between the Earth Nation and the Water Nation. It's one frame practically, but the Water Nation actually wins the event there, even though they both pretty much hit the spikes at the same time. Koopa Troopa, Water Nation, gets a star from that hidden block, you know? Now he's in first place, got a lot of coins there, 100 coins overall. Fire Nation gets another star, that puts him at 4. Koopa Troopa gets another. Was that actually 2? It looks like that was actually 2 stars for Bowser there, an incredible 2-star comeback. Now he's in first place as we move on here to this lit potato game. Looks like it's coming down to just fire and air, and the Air Nation takes it. Only have a couple turns left, so we're getting into this home stretch. Fire Nation gets another star. That puts them at 6, and it's a 2-star lead. Everyone else has 4 stars. Monty Mole, Earth Nation, winning a minigame. He'll be happy about that, but a little bit disappointed he hasn't won more overall. Finally gets a Lack 2-star. He's able to take one of those Fire Nation stars away. Puts him at 5, as well as the Fire Nation at 5 now. The Air Nation also at 5 stars now. It's so close as we head into these final few turns. We've got another tug-of-war game. Same result here. Monty Mole crushing it. Button mashing Wizard. Fire Nation getting another star, though. That puts him at 6. And he gets a present. He's going to be able to pay Lakitu for a star and take one away from Monty Mole. That will put Monty Mole at 4 and the Fire Nation Bowser at 7 stars. Monty Mole, though, has a golden pipe, so he's able to come back up to 5. We're in the final minigame now. Don't Wake Wiggler. Looking good so far. Everyone at 5. Bowser able to get 4 and first one. Earth Nation falls out of favor. All right, so here are the stars going into this.
Oh, so rich.
Bowser in first place with 7. We have the coin star.
Fools. You heard Nation wasn't spending them?
A clear one for Koopa Troopa. Had lots of coins there. The eventful bonus. This is for landing on the most event spaces.
It's probably Dan, yeah.
Unsure who's going to get this one. And it goes to the Fire Nation. That's going to put him at 8 now.
Yay.
Another one.
An ally bonus. Most allies. There were a lot of allies in this game.
Seth has the most.
I think it's a 3-way tie. So
wow. Rip Devin. Okay.
Who won between you two?
I think it might be me now because you stole from Seth, right? I didn't pay the amount you had.
I think it's Nate.
Okay.
Waiting for these final results. And it's Bowser with a clear win, 9 stars. In second place, though, is the Water Nation with 6 stars. Third place, Monty Mole. And in fourth, the Air Nation. Let's see what that did to our final results here as we go to the closing ceremonies. It looks like the contestants are taking their places on the podium in the Avatar House backyard. The Olympic torch, of course, is lit. Can't talk about the closing ceremonies without mentioning the closing ceremony banquet. Of course, the winner of the Olympics was able to select a meal and have the rest of the nations cook dinner for them. In this case, the winning nation chose pizza, so all the nations came together to make 4 different pizzas. It was an absolutely delicious meal, came out great. You can see 3 of the 4 pizzas here. We've got cheese, veggie, and then a pepperoni and onion one. We actually made 2 of the veggies. It looks like our official is ready. She's going to be presenting the 4th place medal, in this case to the Air Nation, who finished with 20 points. Now, as she finished in 4th place, she had to dye her hair, the winner's choosing, so in this case, a nice deep purple. And as you can see, it turned out great. Up next, in 3rd place, we have the Earth Nation here taking off his hat, receiving his bronze medal with 22 points overall. Fun fact about that bronze medal is that it's made with gelt. Jewish chocolate coins. Actually, the foil wrapped around some of them. Receiving his silver medal is the Fire Nation, finishing overall with 23 points. He is, of course, wearing the Chicago flag over his shoulder, representing the Chicago Fire. And in first place, the Water Nation with 25 points. Just a really commanding performance for all of the Olympics and a well-deserved gold. And each of the contestants just wanted to leave one final sign-off message. The Air Nation would like to thank all of her fuzzy friends that bring joy and happiness to her life, all the frontline workers working hard to keep us healthy and safe, and wants to remind you to adopt, don't shop. The Fire Nation would like to thank Mel for supporting him throughout the process. He wants you to follow him on Twitter at big_data_Dan, and wants you to support your local businesses during this time of need. The Water Nation wants to thank everyone who's been watching these videos with him every Tuesday on twitch.tv/betteronpaper. Feel free to stop by for some more first place content. And as for the Earth Nation, I'd really just like to thank all of you who've been watching this. It's been really fun to have people message me saying that they've been trying some of the events on their own or that they're really invested in who's going to win. It's really been a lot of fun to make these, and I really appreciate all of your support. Also, a quick shout out to Megan for making the logo and the metal board. Really can't thank you guys enough for watching. It means so much to have all this support. If you haven't already, please subscribe so the next time I make a video, you're the first to know about it. Have a good day.